Welcome to Gustavus Adolphus College and Christmas in Christ Chapel 2023, Grace Embodied. Tonight, we celebrate the 50th anniversary of this beloved Christmas tradition that showcases the talents of over 300 students who come together to share in the joy and wonder of the holiday season. Thank you to the donors who have established endowments to support this service, including Randall Schreiner and Cynthia Bittner, Sandra and Daniel Buendorf, Patricia Haugen, Daniel and Nova Colander, Ray Lundquist and the late Lorraine Lundquist, and Ben and Ruth Ann Leadholm. And many thanks to John and Anita Young and their Heroic Productions team for providing technical support. On this very special anniversary, we honor the 5 decades of students, faculty, and staff who each year plan, practice, and perform to create a unique worship experience as a gift for our community. And we are also grateful for the alumni, parents, and friends who have attended and cherished this event over so many years. So tonight, may we all sing, "O Come All Ye Faithful," just a little louder as we commemorate the 50th anniversary of Christmas in Christ Chapel, Grace Embodied. Merry Christmas to all, and have a blessed holiday season.
Good evening, friends. Good evening, Christmas in Christ Chapel family. My name is Richard Quentin Elby, in short, Chaplain Elby, or just Elby. I was the first chaplain of this old college founded in 1862. 50 years ago, I had a dream. You might say a vision of how our college community could celebrate the Christmas time at the great festival of the incarnation of God in Christ in this chapel. My idea was that the celebration should include members of all of its departments. Everybody, whatever the discipline, owed something to the celebration, all of its administrators, and then all of its creative directors of music and directors of dance and directors of the visible arts and the organists and all of the student musicians, thousands upon thousands over the years, and the public, public Minnesota and nationwide, and then worldwide, public, thousands on thousands. I can still hear them singing. God was coming to earth in the human voice, memories of heaven. The vision was also the idea that we would use the forms of the ancient liturgies and prayers of the church. Evergreen, and the medieval liturgies and its poetry, and the modern liturgies so full of surprises, evangelical Lutheran and liberal Catholic, all of them together would constitute this high worship in which the eternal Word was becoming human time and flesh in Jesus the Christ, dwelling among us for 50 years at his eternal birthday in his chapel. And we were beholding his glory, and we were participating in it, becoming Christ's to our family, to our neighbor, to our enemy, to all nature, to worlds upon worlds, and each of which we knew more and yet more, and would know more of these eternal relationships. know them family and nature and worlds of beings, as we knew ourselves in God's cosmic Christ as our true selves. Peace.
Thank you. The world whispers to me about what must be done, about empire and war, about efficiency and strength. But there you are, a refusal, your fragility a witness, your dependence an invitation, your cry a reminder. Our finitude is not an embarrassment, because neither was yours. Jesus, this is the great inversion I would not have known, had you not appeared and made yourself small. Jesus, I would have been satisfied with the God that moves mountains and whose breath imparts life, but who never cried in his mother's arms. Blessed are we when we see love at long last, in every small and tender thing, stealing into our world to change us all.
Thank you. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one. The Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God."
Thank you.
Now the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary was engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you will name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us.
If God wished to be born into a world of perfection and peace, we'd still be waiting on a savior of the world. God knows families are messy and that our generations are filled with characters, our stories told slant with time. And so the word of God is mixed up with DNA of those familiar and forgotten heroes, villains, and ordinary folks, entrusted by God to break the rules when rulers were wrong, to act for liberation and for love, and make way for even more.
Don't.
O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. When I look at your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars that you have established, what are human beings that you are mindful of them, mortals that you care for them? Yet you have made them a little lower than God and crowned them with glory and honor. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
Thank you.
Our God, who set the world spinning, should come down for this one reason, to love us into newness, not for gain nor our capitalist fantasies, but for the hope so freely, lavishly given, that we might learn to see, feel, and live Christ's love. Thank you, Christ, the giver and the gift. Amen.
Gracious God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the one true light. Call us out of darkness. Empower us to walk in the light and to proclaim the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Thank you. Christmas in Christ Chapel is a presentation of Gustavus Adolphus College in association with Heroic Productions. For more information about tonight's program or Gustavus Adolphus, please visit us online at gustavus.edu. Thank you for joining us this evening. From all of us here at Gustavus, Merry Christmas.